Hello guys, KP Shamino here with my first video for The Fisherman. So it's going to be my leveling guide. I'm going to show you guys in the first part, the first video, how you need to level from 3 to 10. So why 3? Because the tutorial in Lone Star is going to last until level 3. But first of all, I'm going to show you guys something. So they listened to me yesterday in the video. They lowered the bait coin packs. From 1700 to 1200 and from 2700 to 2000. It's not going to be that hard to get the packs now, because I already had like more than 1000 bait coins on my second playthrough. If you go purely for bait coins, you can get this really easy. So it's not really a problem now. So I'm very happy that they did it. So, but back to the leveling guide. So what do you need to do? So you need to go with the missions, and this video I'm going to play through the leveling after this, because it's a starting video. I know a lot of new guys are coming in, and if I go to skip stuff and just say I use this and this, they are going to have trouble. So it's going to take a little bit longer than the other ones. The other ones are just going to say, this is what I did, this is the gear that I got, and you need to do it until that level. So the moment that you get this mission, assemble is this one. So assemble a sinkerig, you need to go to the Czech Republic. The Czech Republic is the best to level to level 10. Because I'm going to North Carolina to fish for the unique Red Deer Sunfish. Why? Because I don't need to buy other gear, and I'm going to start farming already the bait coins for later. So I'm not going to do the walleye. No, I'm going for the unique Red Deer Sunfish. So what we are going to do is, you just take this mission, then you need to assemble this setup. You can just assemble it yourself, because it's just going to light up the icons. But you need to do one thing that the mission is not saying: buy a bell. The mission is not saying that, because otherwise it's going to be hard to keep fishing over there. What we are going to do is, the moment that I can get the rod pot, so the rod pot is something that you use to put the rod on, and then you don't need to use your hands. We are coming back. So here you can see it, a rod stand, that's at level 6. We're coming back, we buy the stringer, we buy the rod pot, and we buy an extra feeder setup. And then we can fish with two feeders, and it's going to speed up the process. And those feeders we can use in North Carolina too. So you just need to buy two feeders, and that's it until your level 21, 22, I think. And yeah, that's all what you need to do. And it's going to go really fast. So let's have a look. What was I saying again? So I need to buy a bell. Where do you buy the bell? You just go to Terminal Tackles. You buy, is it here? I need to have a look for a moment, guys. I thought it was here, no? Ah, here, common bells, Jesus Christ. So just buy this. It's going to make your life a lot easier. I will give you guys another trick that you can see that you got a bite. Because it's very important that you know that, otherwise you're going to miss a lot of fish. So now we are ready, we can do the mission, and we are going to the Czech Republic. But first, before we go, we need to buy a license. So you just click here. Be sure that you buy the unlimited license, advanced unlimited license, because this is a waste. Just buy it. If you got it, the unlimited license, you will be done for the entire time that you play the game. You never need to look back to the license. Here we go. So now we are good. We got the unlimited license. And what we are going to do now is, we are going to travel. And we are going to start fishing. Now I'm just going to follow the mission. The mission is just going to say to you, just throw on a certain position. And it's just to test a little bit what you need to do. So here we already got some extra money and bait coins. So now you just come here, and then you need to throw in the marker. So how do you do it? Right click. If you right click the mouse, you got the marker. Just put it in the circle. Just click left mouse. And if you are in the box, in the bar, you just click and that's it. So now you just need to fast reel in with shift. Here we go. Now we do it again. There you go. Okay, and now a trick what you can do. So now you need to wait until a fish is biting. So normally you do this, and then you see if the tip is moving, you can get the fish in. But there is a trick. Just push C. You guys will see. Now you see at the bottom right 34 meters. The moment that the 34 meters become 80, you need to strike. You will see it. That's a lot better than just watching the quiver. That's something that a lot of experienced players... Yeah, here. Do you guys saw it? So 80 meters, 80 meters. That's one of the tricks that I want to learn you guys, because you will use it the entire game. And it's one of the tricks that the veterans are using the whole time. So now we need to go a little bit higher with the test. And here we go. That's the first fish. And now we can just throw again, because it's called clipping what I just did. So what is clipping? You just take a certain amount of meters of line. You just put a clip on the reel and you're always going to throw, in my case, 34 meters. So now we zoom in. Here we go. And I think we need to get now another fish. Yes. So we do just the same. The moment that I got 80-80, I'm going to strike. So now we need to wait a little bit. It can take some time. There we go. That's a bite. Therefore, I took the bells with me. So you can hear there is something nibbling. So you can prepare yourself that you got a bite. Otherwise, you need to get focused the whole time on the quiver. Is he going to keep biting? No, it was a fake bite again. It can take some time, but you need to do it. It's very good money. And we need to come here so you can get the bait coin. So we strike again. That's number three. So we need to get one more fish. And then the quest is done. And then I think we need to do one more. Catch five fish, I think. If I'm not mistaken, we draw balls. But we need to watch. So that's number two. And we are almost level four. Okay, we wait again. And that's bottom fishing. So just take the time. But at the end, bottom fishing is the best fishery that you can do in the game. Because at the end, at level 50, you can use 4 bottom rods with rod pot. And you're going to catch a shitload of fish. So this is number 3, and normally the mission is then done. And I'm not sure that I'm going to do the next mission. You guys of course can finish them, but I'm not going to do them. You guys can do all the tutorial missions too, of course, as a starter player. Because I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to put it in a leveling guide, because it's not a leveling guide, it's a tutorial on that moment. So, you guys can see it, level 4 now. Okay, and we can go to Mudwater. And here is the mission. Okay, this one we are not going to do. So, what we are going to do is, you just go to missions. You click here, because you can see it's tutorial. I'm not going to do that. So untrack mission and we are done. So now what we are going to do is you come over here. So this is a very good spot. You're going to catch tench over here. You're going to catch silver bream. You are going to catch everything over here. And that's a spot that we are going to fish. I think there is even fish jumping. So you guys can see it here. So there is activity here. So you guys saw in the tutorial that you need to go to the best time of the day. So you can see it here. We are now in the best time of the day. And what I'm going to do is, be sure that you unclip. We are just going to throw over here. So we are going to clip again. And then we are going to wait. So now we are just going to fish until level 6. And then we are going back to the global market. Get the rod pot. Get the second feeder setup, because if we got a rod pot, we can fish with two feeder setups. on when we are going to assemble a red worm. So we are going to put a red worm on the hook, and on the other one we are going to use this one, pearl barley. That works really well. You can get on the red worm carp, you can get tench on the red worm. It's very universal, and the pearl barley is very good too. So you guys will see it, what I mean, if you buy the second setup. And let's have a look that we can get the fish here. Yeah, there is a bite. So that's something that you are going to see through the game too. So everywhere you come, you will see fish jumping, you see activity, you see circles. That means on that moment, that position is active. So now we got the young common carp. They don't pay that much, but yeah, it's a good fish. So what you can do now is you can put a marker out. So just push M. And you got this device. This device is going to be your best friend through the game. So you can just put a marker on the place where you just had the last fish. You see right away the coordinates here. So you just do this. You can share it with your friends. And if you click on this one, so you will see all the info is here. You can even give a little bit more info. Just click here. Type, for example, maybe the time, because the time is not here, and but now we don't need to do that, but on the later stage of the game you can do it. So it's your best friend, so use it a lot. You need to pay bait coins for it to get more markers, but you can farm bait coins from uniques, achievements, missions in this game. So just use it because it's handy. I will show you guys it. So now I just need to throw on the marker. So here we go. And now we are going to level 6. I'm going to buy the other setup, the rodpot. I'm going to play a little bit. And that's going to be the first leveling guide from level 3 to level 10. And then the next video, I'm going to start at level 10. So I'm still going to adjust some stuff. I already did 2 times a playthrough on the beta. So I got most of the data I got. But now I need to adapt a little bit because the packs are now less bait coins. So it's just a little bit adapting. Because I did a lot of testing. But now I need to say, this is the best rod. This is the line. This is what you need to do. And I still need to test a little bit, but not that much anymore. I already got a view how I want to level from this to level 50. So, it can take some time sometimes, but what I saw was that the experience here is very, very high in this lake. I was really amazed because everybody is going Lone Star, but I don't want to go to Lone Star for the simple reason that Lone Star is still the old mechanic. So it's a little bit too much info for beginner players. So you guys, if you play a little bit longer, you know what I mean. So here is another one, 23, and 23 is a lot of experience. So I think 2 more fish and then we are level 5 and then a couple more. And then we are going to be level 6 and then we are going to buy the equipment really quick. So normally I don't do that, a full walkthrough, but I'm going to do it now that you guys can see what I'm doing. So it takes a little bit longer. I hope that I can make the video in less than 30 minutes. And that would be really, really good. So, but yeah, it's of course a lot waiting. If you don't get a bite, always forward the time with T. You don't need to pay anything for it. And there is another bite. Do we got 80 meters? Yes. And this is a good fish. It can be a carp again. They don't pay that much. Yeah, I think it's a carp. He fights way too hard. So just fight a little bit. You can put your rod a little bit like this. Is this a carp or is this something else? It need to be a carp. There is, yeah, it's a carp. Here we go. And we are getting very close to level 5 now. He was giving 112 money, by the way. So now you guys see that my net is full at the top left. So what you need to do now is just check the next day. It's 5 a.m. that we got the best time, so we just going to forward the time. Don't waste money. Money is more important than experience. If we keep fishing now, you cannot keep the fish and you cannot sell the fish. So now we are going to sell the fish. Every morning at 5 a.m. you are going to sell the fish. So never go back to the global market. No, stay here, or global map, stay here, forward the time and you will see the upkeep is 10 and I'm going to sell my net now. My net is empty and we can start over again. So never go back because you need to pay travel fees. So stay here, just forward. And that was really good that my net was full because a lot of new players got that problem that they don't know how you need to sell your fish. Just forward to the next day and you will be okay. And I hope that the spot is still active because it can change. Yesterday was not a sunny day. We got the best time, but in the Europe lakes, the spots are changing a lot. But I think it's still active because I see a lot of fish jumping still. I see a lot of circles in the water. So there is activity still going on this position. So let's try to get a couple of more fish that we can become level 6. Yeah, and I'm a little bit worried because I think that the spot is dead. But that's no problem. We can adapt on that problem. No, there we are. Still active, 80 meters. Okay. Sometimes it can help a little bit. So if you don't get for a long time a bite on a feeder bottom setup, just reel a little bit in. That's a trick. Sometimes the fish is going to strike, and this is a tench, I think, or is it a crucian? No, it's a young mirror carp. Yeah, we got now level 5. So let's keep this fellow. So that's the first one. Here we go. And here you can see, if you level, you can see what you can buy. So that's very handy. So otherwise, you need to travel again to the global map and you need to check the shop to see what you can buy. So here you can see too. Okay, we are almost level 6 and then it's time to get the new equipment. But it's a lot slower at the moment. You can see it. It's possible that maybe I can switch to a red worm. I already bought them, but I think you can buy them here too. Always remember, the area shop is all... You are going to pay more on the area shop than on the global map. And that was not good. I was too late. So always try to buy, if you go to an area, a fishing area, to buy everything that you need on that area on the global shop and not on the shops in the areas, because they are more expensive. You're going to lose a lot of money. To give you guys an example, if you go to Michigan and you want to buy large minnows, it's going to cost you, I think, in Michigan $1,200 for 5, and on the global market it's going to cost, I think, $800-$900. So that's a lot of money, you know, for only 5 minnows. Come on, fishy. And I just missed the fish. So that's a pity. But it's still active, this spot. And you guys will see, once that we got 2 setups, it's going to speed up the process. It go really fast. Normally, I think on the beta, I leveled in 1 hour, maybe 1.5 hours. Real life, I leveled to level 10. So that's how fast it can go. But now, of course, the start is a little bit slower. Yeah, slower. I'm already level 5, so, and I'm now playing for, what is it, 25 minutes or something. So let's do the trick. Let's reel a little bit. Okay, let's wait now. And here we go. Another carp. Yeah, it's another carp. Is it the young mirror carp again, or is it just a common carp? It's a common. Yeah, it's a common. And you guys can see I can use a little bit a stronger line. So this is 1.2 kilogram, I think, and they are fighting a little bit. Here we go, 21 experience. And what I'm going to do now is we are going to throw a little bit to the left because the carp is not giving that much experience. So you can just throw a little bit to the left. It's total active this place because I want to focus a little bit more on the bream, silver bream, maybe the crucian. The crucian is paying a lot more experience than the carp at the moment. The carp is a good filler for your net, but the other species give more experience. And let's, yeah, this is not a carp, so that's good. So we switched around, and what is this crucian? So this is like the half, and is almost giving the same experience than the carp that we just got. Once again, open the tablet, put a marker, because we are going to use the marker until we are level 10. Here we go. I think 4 more fish, and yeah, then we are level 6, and then it's time to go shopping a little bit. I hope that I got enough money to buy all that stuff. I'm not sure how much that I got, but I think I need at least 15 to 20,000 or something. So I hope that I got that number. Okay, here we go. And this is it the carp again? I think it's a carp again. Or is it something else? No. Common carp. Okay, let's try to get another one. We are almost in the half. And after this fish, we need to go once again to the next day because our net is going to be full. So the net is the most important part in this game. So it sounds really strange, but the more you can put in your net, the more money that you're going to make in one day. It doesn't matter that much in this game because it's the economics are a lot better than in Fishing Planet. So it does not matter that much in this game, but still, you need to have a good net, and you're going to catch more fish then. Come on, fish. Let's reel a little bit. Maybe we can attract some fish. Here we go. Come on, fish. Okay, we are going to switch, guys. So let's switch to the red worm. Because I think that all the fish, it can dry up sometimes. So let's have a look what we got here. Can you buy it here in the baits? Yes, you can buy red worms. They are a little bit more expensive, but they are going to attract another kind of fish, like the tench. and the tenge is paying nice money and the bream too. So let's have a look now on this position that we can get now a little bit faster the fish. So sometimes you need to switch, but always try to go with the worm. Try to go with like bread is working really well too on the low level lakes, because every fish is biting on those baits. Therefore I like to use them. Because the problem is if you go with daw balls or something like that, yeah, that's something for carp. So, but if you're on a spot that there is no carp, you're not going to catch one fish. So. Oh, come on, fish. Yeah, okay. So I moved it a little bit. Let's have a look that we got now. Other species. Yes, the perch. Here we go. 20 experience. So that's not bad. And the net is almost full again. So then we need to forward the time. Okay, that's another one. You guys see what I did? So I switched to another bait and it started working really well. And this is a good fish. If this is a tench, no, it's a crucian, but a very fat one, this one. Yeah, trophy. 62 experience. Here we go. So one more, but now we need to forward the time. So let's have a look. Cloudy again. No, yeah, cloudy again. So 5 a.m. Here we go. Okay, so one more fish, I think, and we are level 6, so that's not so bad. And yeah, then we are going to buy the equipment, and then I'm going to show you guys what you need to do. It's just the same like this, until level 10. So it's even faster than I thought it was going to be. So, okay, here we go, right away. Red worms, they are so good, it's crazy. And this is a very good fish again. Maybe it's a trophy again. Silver bream, 20 experience. No, he stopped biting. It can happen. Maybe it's a very small fish. Because they introduced a new fish here too. I never caught him. I'm not sure what kind of experience he's giving. Come on, fish. Okay, is it level 6? Level 6 in 25 minutes, so that's not bad. And this is a good fish. What the hell? Is this a carp? I think it's this looks like a Prussian carp. No, it's a common, of course, because was already thinking, is this enough? Yeah, it's enough. So, we are now level 6, guys, so let's keep this fellow. So what we need to do now is, so now we unlock a lot of new stuff. We got 15,000 currency, so we are going to leave this place. And now we are going to buy all the other equipment. Then we come back, we do just the same but with two rods. So we are going to speed up the process. So let's close this. So yeah, let's put this mission away. Okay. So now we need to go to the shop. The first thing that we buy is the rod stands. So let's buy this. Here we go. And then we are going to buy a good feeder setup. So let's have a look to the feeders. So we can buy this one. So 2000, we can buy it really quick. Yeah, the Greek Pro 270. Let's buy this one. So normally it comes here. Yeah, here it is already. And you can see now, this rod got a test, a line weight of 3.2 kilogram. So how do you make a good setup in this game? You always need to see that the line is the weakest link. So if you get spooled or you do a mistake with the snag, that you don't break your reel and rot. So now we need to get the reel that is under this number. So let's have a look. A spinning reel. Level 5. Can we get this one? This is under it. But we are 6. Is this worth it? We pay double for like 0.05 kilograms more. No, we are not going to do that. We are going to take this one. The Wingcast. So now we can put this on. And now we need to take a line that is lower and a leader that is lower than 2.25 kilograms. So let's have a look to the shop that we can get a line that is lower than that. So let's go to 6. What is this? 1.8 is lower. And how much is this? 1.82. Ah, we are going to take the mono. This one, 1.8. And now we still need to get the leader. What was this leader? Let me have a look. That's 1.2, so that's perfect. But it's the same like this, so it's not going to be a stronger setup. Yeah, here we at level 7 we can use this, but for the Czech it's going to be okay. But I think I already got this one, no? That's strange, because I thought I bought it. So let's buy this one. So number 3, that's the 1.8, here we go, that's the, yeah, did you guys see it? It didn't give the icon that it was in my box. Then we are going to get a sinker, so between 10 and 40 grams, so around 15 is enough. So let's get a sinker. Here we go. So we can put this on. We are going to buy a little bit a bigger hook. Like a 4. So here by 4. Buy 1 too, because you're going to need it on the Redeer Sunfish. Can we already buy ones? Yes, let's buy ones too. And we need a bell too, of course. A bell. So now we can take this one. It's a little bit the sensitivity, that's the difference. So, okay. So hook 4. We are going to put Pearl Barley. No, we are going to put Red Wortels on this one. And Pearl Barley back on the other one. Or maybe bread. Yeah, we need to get the bells. Where are the bells? Ah, here is the bell. Yeah, backpack is full, of course. Okay, wet hook. Let's put 8 in the home, because we don't need it. Okay, this setup is now ready. We can use it. This one we are going to put Pearl Barley back on. And the last thing, the most important, I almost forgot it. So let's get the stringer. Here by the stringer. And how do you equip it? So you click here on the icon. Then you go here home. You take this. You put it here. And the rotpot is already on its place. So yeah, and now we go just back. And now we are going to fish with 2 feeder rods, and it's going to speed up the process. And that's what you need to do until your level 10. So let's fish a little bit, and then I'm going to end the video, because it's already a long video. So let's go back to the position, because the markers are still out. So you need to push 0 Or press 9, sorry, press 9, you need to press to get the robot out. And first have a look, we are back in Cloudy, so it's going to work. So let's push 9, and you guys can now see that we can already get 10 kilograms in our net, or stringer. So that's a very big difference. So let's throw this on this position. Is it right? Peak time? Yes. And what you need to do now is shift 1 and you put it in the rod pot. Then you take number 3 and you throw that on the other one. So now we are fishing with 2 rods. And that's what we are going to do the entire leveling. So we're just going to get better rods the whole time. Because, as I already said, I think that bottom rods are the best to level in this game. It's going to be the fastest way, because you always can use more than one. Of course, you can use 2 bottom rods too, or 1 bottom rod and a spinning rod. It doesn't matter. But you need to use... Oh, and we need to clip this. So I almost forget to clip it, that we can see the bite, but I think it was the other one. So I'm going to catch now a couple of fish. And it's just to show you guys it. But now you can see the process is going to speed up. We got now 2 rods, 2 times more fish probably. We can focus on different species on the both rods. And the problem is I cannot see which rod is going to go. So I hear the sound, but it can be the rod that is in the rod pot too. So let's wait a little bit. Yeah, and just... Ah, okay. Come on, fish. Just when I got 2 rods, the fish is not biting anymore. It can happen. It can happen. So, you guys see at the top, you see now it's a cloudy day. But under that, you see the wind. And at the right, you see the water temperature. So, it's a cloudy day, but it can be a different day too. Because the setting is different. So... If you got a very good day, write it. Yeah, we got a fish. Here we go. So I saw 75 popping up. Here we go. Perch. And that's what you need to do, guys. So that was it. My leveling guide from 3 to 10. Normally, I think in 1 hour you can do it. And I hope to see you guys in the next leveling guide. So thanks for watching. Have fun. Bye-bye.